All right, this is pretty exciting. We're going to look at order out of chaos. We're not just going to pick numbers out of the air. I've actually organized something here for us. I've got some Uno playing cards. Okay, I've got 9 and they're all different, which is important. So first of all, what I'm going to do is I'm going to give it a very light shuffle. Let's put it out here. So we've got 9, 6, 4, 5, 1, 7, 2, 3, and 8. Okay, so let's look at these. So these are 9 cards in a particular order, particular permutation. Let's see if we can find 4 cards that are in ascending order. So, ascending order. So we can see we've got a 4 here. We've got a 5. We've got a 7. And we've got an 8. Okay, so they didn't need to be right next to one another. But we found 4, 5, 7, 8. Okay, how about 4 cards in descending order? All right, so 9 is a good start because that's as high as you can get. So we've got 9, 6, 5, and 1. Or we could have had 2, or we could have had 3. So, look at this here. Now, Brady, let's look at this. We've got 9 cards, so that means that we have 9 factorial different ways to organize them, which is 362,880 permutations. But there is 1,764 ways that you can organize these 9 cards such that there are no 4 numbers in ascending order or descending order. And I know what you're thinking. Why is that a square number? Yeah?
I wasn't, but I am now.
Because it is. It's 42 squared. And the reason why is because it actually follows this marvelous little formula here. 9 factorial on 1 to the 1 by 2 to the 2 by 3 to the 3 by 4 to the 2 by 5 to the 1 all squared. So the point is, this is some serious maths. So 1,764 divided by 362,880 is approximately equal to 0.5%. So at chance, if you just take it at random, there's a 0.5% chance that you can actually put this in an order so that there's no 4 increasing or decreasing. Okay? So Brady, would you like to make some money?
Yeah.
I'm willing to put down £20, okay? £20 against a probability of 0.5% at random, but I think you're pretty smart. So if you're able to organize this in a way that there's no 4 increasing or decreasing, that's yours.
Gosh. Well, how long have I got?
Oh, you got as long as you like. Okay, my £20 is looking safe. Do you want to have another go?
No.
It'll be a smaller denomination. All right, here we go. A little bit of, that's the only time I'm interested in gambling, actually just testing you. Okay, so this is it. This is the way we do it. What you do is you split it up into groups of 3 and you go like this. You go da da, da da, da da. Okay? So looking at it from left to right, what I've done is that you can see it goes 3, 2, 1, 6, 5, 4, 9, 8, 7. So the maximum of descending is 3, 3, 3. And then if you want to go for ascending, all right, what you do is you basically, you can only take 1 from each of these groups. So it doesn't matter which one. So you could go like 2, 5, 8, for example. Or you could pick any one. So you could go 1, 4, 7, right? But if we add 1 more card, okay, the beautiful 0, all bets are off, literally. And I'll tell you why. It's because if you have 10 cards, what happens is if I put my 0 here, wherever I put it, I'm always going to create 4 ascending or 4 descending, right? So if I put my 0 here, you can see it goes 0, 1, 4, 7 in that particular permutation. If I put it here, it doesn't change. If I put it here, it doesn't change. Okay, if I put it here, all right, I no longer can do that here, but now, look what I've got, 3, 2, 1, 0. And that doesn't change if I put it here, 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 or here. Okay, now, that is not only just for that particular permutation. It so happens that for 10 factorial permutations, which is 3, 6, 2, 8, 8, 0, 0, there are now 0 ways to find no 4 numbers ascending or descending order. No, right? Which is a strong result, which means we've got order out of chaos. Why should that be the case?
There's a second video in which Simon explains all the mathematics behind what's going on in this video. If you'd like to see it, there'll be a link in the description and on the screen. It's about 8 or 9 minutes long, so I thought I'd do it separately and keep this video a bit shorter. If you'd like to see my really embarrassing attempt at arranging the cards, which cost me £20, I will make that available, but there's going to be a bit of a catch. Have a look in the video description and I'll explain how you can see it.